You're also very critical of Lincoln, his hypocrisy. You know, the usual historians say, look, these were other times. You have to forgive them this. They at least helped create a constitution with a Bill of Rights. You're more merciless on Lincoln, who you called the tyrant. Could you describe his back and forth with the border states and his position on slavery and what the real cause, you believe, of the Civil War was?
Question. Did the Emancipation Proclamation free the slaves? Answer. It established and permitted slavery in the border states. You really have to read the document before you can understand that. Question. Was Abraham Lincoln interested in freeing the slaves? No. Abraham Lincoln said, I don't care if we have slaves or not. I just have to keep these southern states in the government because my job is to keep the country together because we don't have an income tax. And if we don't collect duties from the ports, and most of them are in the southern states, we can't have a federal government if that money is not coming in. Look, Lincoln arrested 3,000 journalists and publishers and editors in the North. These are not guys with guns shooting at federal soldiers. These are people arrested because of their words, because of what they said about the war. And he had them tried before military tribunals, every one of which was invalidated after Lincoln's death by a Supreme Court that he had just appointed that said the Constitution exists in good times and in bad. When the legislature of Maryland was about to enact legislation he didn't like, he sent troops to arrest every single legislator. He argued against the right to secession, but he caused West Virginia to secede from Virginia so we could have two more senators in the Senate and more representatives in the House of Representatives. He was the most tyrannical, most disingenuous, least faithful to the Constitution president we've had in American history. His troops burnt courthouses, raped women, robbed banks, killed civilians on a large scale for the first time in the history of the world, all in the name of a defensive war.
And you say it was the prime cause, was not slavery.
In my view, the prime cause was Lincoln's fear that the government would collapse if it didn't have economic activity from the South, particularly duties and excise taxes collected at every port from Wilmington to Houston. There were only three other ports in the country, Boston, Philadelphia, and New York. All the others were in the South. They lost 75%, or were due to lose 75% of the income from those ports.